हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज क्वेश्चन नंबर 3 ऑफ एक्सरसाइज 2.3। इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव डिस्कस फर्स्ट एंड सेकंड। सो हियर इट्स अ बाई क्वाड्रेटिक पॉलीनोमियल एंड यू नो दैट द नंबर ऑफ डिग्री, व्हाट इज द नंबर ऑफ डिग्री इज 4 एंड वी नो दैट नंबर ऑफ डिग्री इज इक्वल टू नंबर ऑफ सॉल्यूशंस, राइट? सो यू कैन सी दैट नंबर ऑफ डिग्री इज 4, तो सॉल्यूशंस आर 4. And in this question, this is very important sum for board exams. I have seen this sum so many times. So one root is given here, root 5 upon 3, and the second is minus root 5 upon 3, right? So first of all, you know, this is given in the root form, and we want the two more roots, because there are 4 roots and 2 roots are given and 2 roots we have to find. So for getting a roots, you know, by hit and trial, there is a one way. But here we will not use hit and trial because we will use these 2 roots. So how we will use it? First of all, we will convert into expression form, right? And multiply. If I express this particular root, it will shift here in minus, and it will shift here in plus, and we will find the product. Why we are doing product? Because after product we will get a quadratic form. Because if we do the single one, so we will get the quotient in, you know, cubic polynomial. Why I am saying, suppose what is the degree here? 4. Suppose 4 degree polynomial is divided by degree 4. Suppose degree 4 polynomial is divided by degree 1. So the quotient will come of degree 3, 4 minus 1. Then again we have to use hit and trial. So what is the option here? If I divide it by 2, so degree of the quotient will be 2, and then we can use middle terms theorem. That is why the better way will be if I divide it by the product of both factors. So what is the product here? X square minus 5 upon 3. And this fraction form, what we can do, we can take it common, 3x square minus 5, and this 1 upon 3 will not give any type of effect because it is a part of the factor. It is just increasing the value of the factor. This particular expression is responsible. So what we will do here, this 3x square minus 5 will divide this particular polynomial. You can see. Now the procedure is same as we have done in question number 1, right? So we will multiply it by x square, you can see there, right? So what we will get? 3x raised to the power 4, now here minus 5x square. Why am I putting here minus 5x square? Because they both are like terms, minus and plus, and it will be 6x cube only. It is 3x square and minus 10x, right? So now next is we will multiply this 3 by 2 so that we can make it 6, and by x, so it will be what? 6x cube, and it will be minus 10x. So minus plus and cancel. Always we will change the sign here. Now what is left here now? 3x square minus 5. So we will multiply by 1 only, because 3x square is here and 3x square is here. 3x square minus 5, then minus plus and cancel. So this is the question part. The question part I am writing here, x square plus 2x and plus 1. So what is the middle term splitting? X plus x, right? This is, I think we have done so many sums of middle term splitting in 9th class. So what I am getting? X plus 1 and x plus 1. So if further, because this is the algebraic form, so can we write in root form? It is minus 1, it will be other roots I am writing here, it is plus minus. So 4 roots we got, right? So this is the one, I think, one and good way to find the 2 more roots for a biquadratic polynomials, right? In question number 4, if you see x cube minus 3x square and plus x plus 2 when divided by gx, we get the quotient and remainder. Quotient is x minus 2 and remainder we are getting minus 2x plus 4, right class? So how can we find gx here? So I want to tell you, can you know, do you know this one, Euclid's division algorithm? What is division algorithm? Dividend is equal to quotient into divisor and plus remainder. So I have written in this form. So what I will do, this remainder I will shift here. X cube minus 3x square plus x plus 2, it will be plus 2x and it is minus 4, and x minus 2 I am putting here. First of all, we will simplify it. So we are getting this one, we are getting 3x and minus 2 here. This x minus 2 will come and divide, and this is here. Now you can see, if this particular number, what is the result will come after dividing this polynomial by x minus 2. Now you can see here, you know, gx depends, you know, this quotient, now it is a divisor for gx, right? And polynomial we have changed, because in polynomial we have done remainder minus. So here you can do the division here. So x minus 2 when divided by 3x square plus 3x minus 2, so what you will get here, it is x square, x cube minus 2x square minus plus, it is minus x square plus 3x minus 2. Now it is minus x, if I am putting here, so it is x square minus 2x, so minus plus, what is left here, it is plus, so it will be minus, so it is x minus 2, so it is plus 1, x minus 2 minus plus, it means we are getting 0. So what is the result here, x square minus x plus 1. So gx is x square minus x plus 1. You know class students, this division, if you do more and more practice such type of divisions, because this will take time and you have to make your speed in this particular process, right? Now I am coming to the next question, number 5. Give examples of polynomial px, gx, qx and rx which satisfies the division algorithm. Right, so degree of px is equal to degree of qx, degree of qx is equal to degree of rx. So you have to give some suitable examples here, right, which satisfy the division algorithm. Means division algorithm should be satisfied there. So I am giving you some examples so that you can understand this one. So question number 5 I have written here. Okay, on the other side I have denoted px, I am denoting by dividend, gx we will call it divisor, rx is the remainder, and qx will behave like a quotient. Now this one I have written Euclid, you know, dividend is equal to what, quotient into divisor plus remainder. Now this is the first condition we have to see. You have to select, you know, there are so many choices, infinite choices, you can say that. Degree of px should be equal to degree of qx, right? And on the basis of this, we have to find the, you know, all the polynomials, means all polynomials, px, gx, any example you can give, where, you know, this equation is getting satisfied. So, you know, you have to see some examples here. For example, I am taking, you know, if degree is same, means if suppose I am taking a 2 degree polynomial, so I will take a 2 degree polynomial of qx also. If both are of 2 degree, so definitely I have told you, because quotient depends on the difference of the degree of, you know, dividend and divisor. So if there is a degree 2 and it is degree 2, the quotient will be 0, degree polynomial type, and remainder maybe it will be a constant or it can be a zero, it depends. So you know, we can take so many examples here. So suppose I am taking any 2 degree polynomial, so I have taken some examples here. You can see degree of polynomial and degree of quotient should be same. So what you will do, px is you can see here 2 degree and qx I have taken of 2 degree and gx is constant. Obviously it will come constant and rx will is coming with a 1 degree. But we are not treating with rx, but we have to check the both polynomial. You can take in place of so many things because it doesn't matter. Suppose I am saying, like for example, you are saying 3x square minus 2x square plus 5x plus 3 divided by, sorry, cube, for example, I am taking. And suppose I am taking x cube minus 3x square plus 5. So it is also a part of this because degree of polynomial and degree of, you know, we are taking divisor here. So in this case, what we are doing, if you want the same degree for qx, so what we will do here, you can take 3x cube, suppose 2x plus, 2x square plus 5x plus 7. So what we will do, we will divide it by, suppose I am saying it is divided by 3. So definitely your answer will come in the 3 degree form because we are dividing by a 0 degree polynomial. So it means you can take so many examples. I have taken the solution of, it's given in your book also. So in place of this, you can put so many examples here, right? So there is no worry. But yes, you have to, suppose I am not putting this one according to answer, and the constant I am also getting change. Suppose I am dividing by 3 and I am putting here 3x cube plus 2x square plus 5x plus 7. So you have to check what it will become and what it will come, right? In the same way, the degree of quotient and remainder should be same. So what is the procedure? So if you are putting here x cube and your gx should be less than 1 only, then your quotient and remainder will be same of degree polynomials, same degree type, right? And you know, for remainder 0 there are so many examples. You can take any one. Suppose I am taking this one and I will check where it is getting 0. So I have seen it is at minus 2, when we put the value of x2, then it is getting 0. So I will say that yes, it is the possibility here, right? So this is exercise 2.4, students. In the question number 1, you can see we have to verify the relationships of zeros and coefficients, and I think you can do these sums, right? It is related to cubic polynomial and we have discussed some examples in the previous videos also. So we are starting from second question. Second question is, find the cubic polynomial with sum and sum of the product of its zeros taken 2 at a time and the product of zeros. If suppose let alpha, beta, gamma are the roots, right? Roots of cubic polynomial. So it is, what is given? Alpha plus beta plus gamma, sum of the roots. It is 2 and product of, the sum of the product of two roots taken 2 together. So you can see that gamma alpha, it is minus 7, and alpha beta gamma, it is minus 40. Now I want to ask you, or I want to take you to the one part of quadratic. Suppose there are alpha and beta, two roots. So how can you find the polynomial by seeing these roots? So what is that when x square minus sum of the root x plus product of the root? This is the procedure to find the quadratic polynomial with the help of roots. But here also we will follow the same thing. X square minus sum of the roots, x cube sum of the roots plus product of the roots and minus alpha beta gamma. So this is the cubic polynomial condition. So same here I am doing x square minus sum of the root is 2x, x square plus minus 7x and minus plus 14, right? So it will be x cube minus 2x square minus 7x plus 14. So this is the answer. I think this is similar to quadratic polynomial. Only you have to just remember there is a one term which will be extra here. that is alpha beta plus beta gamma and plus gamma alpha. Right. Now the next question, number 3. So this is again cubic polynomial is given. Zeros are given in this form. You can see here a minus b, a and a plus b. Now see, this is alpha, this is beta and this is gamma. So if I see, suppose I want to find alpha plus beta plus gamma, what is the value? So what definitely I will say coefficient of x square upon coefficient of x cube, right? So it is minus 3. 1 minus is from formula side and 1 minus it, this particular coefficient is having, so it will be plus 3, right? If you will see that 3 is what, sum of these three roots. And suppose what is the roots are here, a minus b, a and a plus b. So it means this 3 will be equal to this one. Minus b cancelled, it is 3a and it is 3, so a is what, 1. Now what is the next condition we can take? I think this will be a better option for us if we take alpha beta gamma. So alpha beta gamma is constant part upon coefficient of x cube. This particular denominator will be same in all. So what is it? Minus 1 upon 1. It is minus 1 only. And what is it? Alpha beta gamma. What is alpha? A minus b. What is beta? A and a plus b. So it is minus 1. If I put here 1 minus b, it is 1 only. If we do not write 1 here, then it is fine. So it will be minus 1 equal to 1 square minus b square. So this 1 I am shifted, b I am shifting here. This is 1 plus 1, it is 2. So b is equal to plus minus root 2. So it means now a is what? A is 1 and b is plus minus root 2. Right. So this is very important sum also. Sometimes it is asked in competitions. Now I am coming to the next part. Question number 4. So this is question number 4 and polynomial you can see here. X raised to the power 4 minus 6x cube minus 26x square plus 138x minus 35. This question is similar to exercise 2.3, question number 3. But what is the meaning of this plus or minus here? It means x is equal to 2 plus root 3 and x is equal to 2 minus root 3. Right? But we know that there are two factors is given, other two factors we have to find. So what procedure we have followed on the time? We have shifted this particular number here. And this one is also. And we will find the product of both, because that product of both factors will divide this one. We will get the quotient in quadratic form. So you can see that rather than to multiplication, we can use identity here. This x minus 2 will work as a, under root 3 will work as a b. So a square minus b square, so it will be x square minus 4x plus 1. Now this x square minus 4x plus 1 will divide this particular polynomial, right? So what is the result? Simple division. Now this will be minus 4x cube, it is plus x square, then change the sign. Okay, this will be minus 2x cube, this will be minus 27x square, right? And it is 138 itself. Now we have to see this one, minus 2 and 1x is required, so that it can be a 2x cube and we multiplied here, and it will be what, plus 8x square, and it is minus 2x. Change the sign, plus minus and plus cancel, it is minus 35x square, it is 140x and it is 35. Suppose and x square is same, but only minus 35 we have to put here. So minus 35x square, it will be 140x, it is minus 35. You can see that last all terms are getting cancelled. So x square minus 2x is the result here. So this x square minus 2x and minus 35 is containing other two factors. So what we will do here, middle term splitting. So you know very well, 7 and 5 will be the factors. So it is x minus 7 plus 5, x minus 7. So it is x minus 7 and x plus 5. So if you want to write in a factor form, so it will be x is equal to 7 and it will be minus 5, and other two factors are here, 2 plus minus root. I hope this question was much easier than the previous one, because we have done such type of sum. It means this is the second sum we are doing here. If you will do, you know, two or three sums like this, so definitely there will be no chance for error. And I think 99% this type of particular sum will be definitely asked in board exams, right? And last sum, which is fifth sum, it is again very important sum in my view, because you know this sum generally in so many books has done by different ways. But I hope if we follow the systematic way or organized way, in simple way, then we can find a result in a, you know, simply in a simplest form without doing so much efforts, right? So question number 5, x raised to the power 4. You can see this is the divisor is containing k, and you know, after dividing, the according to question they were saying x plus a will be the remainder, but we will see that it is x plus a, or it will come in similar type of form. Definitely it will come in similar type of form when we will compare with this x plus a. So simple way is we will do this division in a same way, and at the last we will compare, right? So ready? So I am starting from the first, x square, it will be x raised to the power 4, it is 2x cube, it is kx square, okay, minus, plus and minus, this one. What is the result here? 4x cube, right? It is 16 and minus k. Be very careful when you are noting down the sign of this term, because now it is minus, not plus. Sometimes by mistake we write here plus and the whole question becomes wrong on that time, right? So now it is 25x. Now it is minus 4x, we will multiply in this to make it minus 4x cube, and it will be minus minus plus 8x square, and it is minus 4kx, right? So it is plus, it is minus, it is plus. Now you can see that 16 minus k minus 8, minus 8 because minus is with 8 now, and here plus term is what, 4k, so I am writing plus term here first, and minus 25, right? And what is left? 10 is left. Now what is, can we write it 8 minus k? So I am writing it 8 minus k, right? It is 8 minus k. Now we have to multiply by 8 minus k here, so it will be 8 minus k x square. Now this 8 minus k will multiply with minus 2. I am putting here plus, this minus 2 I will multiply here, I will get minus 16, and minus minus plus 2k and x, and this 8 minus k will multiply here also, it will be 8k minus k square, right? 8k minus k square, minus minus and minus, cancel. Now this is 4k minus 25, and this minus will change the sign, so it will be plus 16 and minus 2k, and x is here, and here 10 minus 8k and plus k square, change the sign of both, right? Now can we simplify it more? So I am putting here or, it will be 2k and it will be 9x, and it is 10 माइनस 8k प्लस k स्क्वायर। नाउ इफ यू कंपेयर, आई एम राइटिंग द रिजल्ट हियर, सो व्हाट इज द रिमाइंडर अकॉर्डिंग टू द क्वेश्चन, x प्लस a, एंड अकॉर्डिंग टू अस इट इज x माइनस 2k माइनस 9x प्लस 10 माइनस 8k प्लस k स्क्वायर। सो मींस what is the coefficient of x here, 1 and here 2k minus, both are equal because remainders are same, so 2k minus 9 is equal to 1, 2k equal to 10, so k equal to 5, right? And what is a, remaining part is a, so 10 minus 8k plus k square will be a here, and can, what is the value of k here, 8 into 5 plus 5 square, so definitely you will get minus 5, and this is your final answer. Question is very easy, but you have to be very careful why you are multiplying, because there are, you know, much chances of error with minus or plus. So thank you class for watching this video.